very few words. Well, you have to understand that in the world you have 1 billion people who lack safe access to drinking water, and as a result 2.6 million die each year, mostly children. But the good news is that not a lot of people actually know that a large fraction of this population live in coastal areas where they have access to an incredible source of energy, which is ocean waves. And that's what we do at Result Marine Energy. We use ocean waves to desalinate seawater and provide fresh water for these people. And so we identified two countries, South Africa and Cape Verde, and decided to launch our technology in this place first. But then our technology could have a much broader impact in South America, all over Africa, Southeast Asia. I mean, the number of places in the world that could benefit from our technology is a lot. We have been working in Cape Verde for the last 3 years. I mean, you have to understand that Cape Verde is one of the driest places in the world. It has no river, a very limited aquifer, and most of the water is actually already desalinated. But on the top of that, Cape Verde has no indigenous source of energy, so they have to import all the oil and all the diesel necessary to drive this desalination system. So as a result, the water in Cape Verde is actually one of the most expensive in the world. But Cape Verde is also very good because it has excellent wave energy resources. So the idea is, our plan for the coming years is actually to test at commercial stage our technology in Cape Verde, in the island of San Vicente. And we already identified a site location where we want to do a pilot that could, you know, enable us to expand at commercial stage, and we are working with a local water and power utility, with a local government. I mean, Cape Verde is a very exciting market for us because it's really epitomized, you know, the problem that we are solving of providing water to, you know, island nation and developing countries. The funding of SME is really the main barrier for us to bridge the gap from where we are now up to the commercial pilot, you know, what's the so-called valley of death. Having the endorsement from the African Development Bank actually brings more than just money. It brings endorsement, as I just mentioned, but also it shows that there is an interest for the technology and for, you know, the financing of this technology at commercial stage. So we are really hoping that this will trigger, you know, additional grant money, additional funding that will enable us, you know, to finance the rest that needs to be financed to get a commercial pilot within 2-3 years.